You're looking at the fifth generation Chevrolet Tahoe. It's a full-size SUV that you can use for towing, off-roading, or lugging around up to 9 people and their stuff.
But is it any good?
Good question on camera, Micah. A smart place to start is inside. If you've ever languished in the third row of an older Tahoe, the latest rendition will be a revelation. Grab handles and wide access past the sliding second row make it easy to climb aboard the third row.
Once here, you'll find adult-worthy head and leg room, and unlike in the previous Tahoe, you sit in a normal position instead of with your feet up by your butt. That's no good. That's good.
In short, there's no bad seat among the Tahoe's 3 rows, and though ours seats 7, you can equip a Tahoe to seat up to 9 people, facilitated by a front bench seat that's sadly only available on the base LS trim.
Another Tahoe strength is its ability to haul cargo, both big and small.
Luggage space behind the third row has grown substantially versus the previous generation, landing at a generous 25.5 cubic feet. That's more than the Ford Expedition. With all seats lowered, capacity swells to 122.9 cubic feet, which is a lot. And doing so from the cargo area is easy thanks to optional second row releases and powered third row seats that motor up and down with haste. For smaller items, there are countless nooks and crannies to exploit, including a huge center console, tons of storage in the doors, this little spot on the dash, and a convenient card holder to the left of the steering wheel that'll ensure you never lose your parking slip.
So you can carry lots of people and their stuff. Cool. What else can you do with the Tahoe?
One thing you can do is tow up to 8,400 pounds. You can also go off-road with the $3,000 four-wheel drive option, perhaps to extra rugged locales if you choose the Z71 trim with its 2-speed transfer case, all-terrain tires, and front skid plate. You can also go the opposite direction and choose the RST trim, whose street-focused enhancements include 22-inch wheels and dark trim. Stylish. Get the Tahoe moving, and ride quality shines thanks to an independent rear suspension that's new for Tahoe generation number 5.
Let's see how the Tahoe deals with this big old bump. 3, 2, 1. Smooth.
Spring for the optional air suspension plus magnetic dampers, and the Tahoe moves with near luxury levels of refinement. While enjoying that ride, a high hood and thick C-pillars do somewhat hinder the view out. If visibility restrictions or the Tahoe's hefty dimensions give you pause, consider the 360-degree camera option and its array of helpful views.
I'll also say that even though it is a large SUV, the Chevy Tahoe doesn't steer like a big, heavy SUV.
While the Ford Expedition uses a turbocharged V6, Chevy still believes in the power of naturally aspirated V8s. The base unit is a 5.3-liter, while a 6.2-liter is reserved for the fanciest high country trim. And here are the fuel economy figures. You get all that? Good. And for diesel fans, Chevrolet also offers a 3-liter inline 6-cylinder turbo diesel with tons of torque and stellar fuel economy.
Our test vehicle has the 5.3-liter V8, and it does a commendable job getting up the speed. Vroom! Conversely, I dislike how the brake pedal feels. It's got this rubbery quality. No good. Bad pedal. Bad pedal.
Regardless of engine, all Tahoes feature a smooth shifting 10-speed automatic transmission that's controlled by this push-pull button arrangement that takes some getting used to. But buttons take up less space than a traditional shifter, so I reluctantly approve. Adjacent to the shift zone in all Tahoe trims is a 10.2-inch touchscreen featuring Apple CarPlay and Android Auto. The interface is simple to navigate, though if you're looking for the volume knob, it's down here.
Reaching all the way to the far side of the screen can be a bit of a stretch, but I do like how they've created this little perch for your hand. So if you're going over like a big bump here, big bump, you can still make very steady inputs. Oh, off on start. No, no.
A basic Tahoe LS trim features 3-zone climate control, 8-way power front seats, and automatic emergency braking for a tick above $50,000, including destination charges. From the Blue Book's perspective, the $4,800 pricier LT trim is a worthwhile upgrade thanks to its hands-free power liftgate, leather seating, and wireless phone charger. We'd also spring for the $790 driver alert package, which bundles blind spot warning, rear parking sensors, and lane keeping assist, though that last feature really should come standard. Other notable options include ventilated front seats, a 10-speaker Bose audio system, and a digital rearview mirror. Indulge your wildest Tahoe dreams, and the price tag soars to nearly $80,000. Price-wise, a base Tahoe stands a few thousand dollars pricier than the Nissan Armada, falls in line with the Toyota Sequoia, and undercuts the Ford Expedition. Though more expensive, the Kelley Blue Book Best Buy award-winning Expedition is a strong competitor, boasting a range of compelling features and a superior max tow rating. If you need more space than the Tahoe allows, check out the Chevrolet Suburban, which measures 15 inches longer and about $2,700 pricier than its Tahoe kin. I should also note that if all you need is a roomy SUV with three rows of seats, the current crop of quote-unquote mid-size SUVs offers plenty of space at a much lower price. Looking good, Telluride.
Even so, if you need the capabilities of a full-size SUV, the Chevy Tahoe has never been better.